Hello and welcome to my presentation on intrusion detection in energy systems. I would like to show you today that IDS can be an important building block in the OT security processes around substations and SCADA systems. Sometimes all those security measures are focused on the control center side of things. But I think that especially the substations are an underestimated attack surface, because there's many of these substations out there in the grid, and many of them don't have enough protection against physical intrusions or cyber intrusions. So let's have a look at the OT security processes in the power grid. And here, the NIST Cybersecurity Framework is a very good guideline. This cybersecurity framework has been used in many national security regulations, in EU member states, and all across the world, this model has been used. So I'm going to use it as a rough guideline here. So the security processes are roughly can be split up into these five functions. So the first function is to identify the situation. What are my assets there? What are the attack vectors? How somebody could reach down into my SCADA and substation networks? And also the risks involved with these assets and the attack vectors. And then I'm going to start with the attack vectors with the highest risk to protect them against intrusion from adversaries. But what sometimes is forgotten is that the detection step is an important part of the security process, because only using detection I'm able to notice if some threat is there in my network, and only then I can respond and recover my services there. In the response, it's not only important to get rid of the threats, but it's also important to learn for the next time what has happened there. And then, of course, especially in the OT side, I need to define processes first how I can recover certain affected services. So let's have a look at substations now. What are the attack vectors on substations first? So I will go through that briefly here now. And so the first two attack vectors are probably very well known. Attack vector number one in this picture has been used in many cyber attacks on OT systems, and also in the most famous cyber attack on a substation in the Ukraine, 2016. Attack vector number two is also feasible. So an attack originating from the control center affecting the devices in the substation is possible regardless of the SCADA protocols used. Something which is often forgotten is that also the Stuxnet kind of cyber attacks using engineering laptops directly connected to the devices in the substations are also feasible. So this happened 10 years ago in the Stuxnet cyber attack, but it can happen again in substations as well. Another topic are testing PCs, especially for SCADA testing and the signal testing involved with IEC 61850 or without. Typically, Windows software is plugged into the network of the substation or into the SCADA network. And this poses, of course, also an attack vector. Another attack vector number five here is the testing equipment, the testing devices used to test the protection or the communication functions in the SCADA system or in the substation. And also they pose an attack vector. And we as a tested vendor are investing a lot over the last years to make sure that this attack vector number five becomes unattractive for an attacker. What also needs to be considered, of course, is the storage of the files in those systems. So for the testing files and the engineering files, those file servers virtually belong to the secure perimeter of a substation, and they need to be secured in the same way. If you now apply intrusion detection in such a substation, or generally in OT systems, there are mainly two approaches available, and both of them have certain drawbacks involved. The first and most the oldest approach is the signature-based approach. It is the same as with our virus scanner, The problem is it can only detect attacks which are known, which have an entry in this deny list, and only then a certain attack or threat can be detected. And so for power systems, this is clearly not a good approach. So there are other systems available which use a baseline approach. And with this approach, the systems look into the communication in the OT network for 2 weeks or 2 months, for example, and they learn the average behavior, the average protocol values generically for all the communication involved in the OT network. So this sounds feasible. It can then, after this learning phase, be switched to operational, and then it will alarm on each significant deviation from the average. The problem is this approach has many false alarms because of the seldom activity like switching operations, routine protection testing, and other maintenance. So, but this is not the biggest problem, the amount of false alarms. The bigger problem is how do you analyze these alarms? They are often related directly to the protocol communication, and you need people who are equally qualified in cybersecurity and in those OT specialized SCADA and substation protocols. And this is the problem. You don't have those specialists available 24/7 for alarm analysis. With StationGuard, we used a different approach. And the approach in StationGuard uses the fact that substations and the power grid in general is quite predictable. And with substations, according to IEC 61850, we even have the advantage that we can use the machine-readable documentation of the whole substation and the communication especially, which is in so-called SCL files. And the intrusion detection system StationGuard can read these files, and then it knows the behavior of the substation. It can then compare each and every packet in the communication against this system model. And with that, it can be it can precisely detect what is right and what is wrong in this communication. Of course, you can then also consider the whole substation life cycle in this system model. For example, maintenance and switching operations and routine protection testing, these things are already considered in the system model. What is especially interesting is that StationGuard is not just comparing and detecting cyber threats. StationGuard verifies all the communication against this system model, and this verification allows us also to detect functional problems. And this brings me to the aspect of functional monitoring, which can also be performed by intrusion detection systems. StationGuard can, for example, detect configuration changes in the IEDs involved with the communication. It monitors the specific configuration revision fields in the messages, and it can detect if there is a deviation, if somebody changed the configuration in the devices. It also monitors the communication continuously and compares it with the timestamps in the messages so that it can detect excessive transmission delays. With this, you can detect denial of service situations in the IEDs, but you can also detect network failures and delays, and especially, and that is the most frequent case, time synchronization errors in the substation. What StationGuard can also do is it can log critical events, for example, switching operations or any other control commands, as well as file transfers, including the file names. Quite a frequent question is, what about the other protocols involved? So, of course, with IEC 61850, StationGuard performs a fully detailed analysis using the system model. But also all other communication protocols are covered by the same system model. Any communication between any two parties in the network needs to be allowed and registered in the system model beforehand, otherwise there will be an alarm. StationGuard performs deep packet inspection for many other protocols like DNP, the 104 protocol, Modbus, and many IT protocols such as FTP and HTTP. It detects not just the protocol, but also the application using it behind. And so StationGuard compares the MAC addresses and IP addresses of the devices involved, but also the VLAN ID and the protocol and application. For proprietary engineering protocols, which are frequently used in substations, we provide an additional function called maintenance mode, and with that you can limit what is allowed during specific phases of the life cycle of a substation. And then you have a more specific intrusion detection depending on the situation. Another point I would like to discuss today is the intrusion detection system alarm display needs to be accessible for OT engineers, because OT engineers, so especially protection and SCADA engineers, are needed in the analysis of the alert cause. So they are needed in the response process, in the cybersecurity processes. And with StationGuard, we designed the user interface in a way so that OT engineers, such as protection and control engineers, immediately feel comfortable with the user interface, because we're using a graphical diagram very close to the single line diagram of the substation. And as you can see here in that screenshot, intrusion detection system alarms are depicted graphically in that system diagram as this red arrow that's coming from the test PC in that feeder number one here. Another important topic in the OT security processes is the asset inventory. So it is important for the identification of your risk and that you get to know what are the assets communicating and what are the firmware versions, for example, of these assets in order to perform a risk analysis. With StationGuard, you can export this asset inventory automatically because it detects all the assets in the network based on the passive traffic analysis. But StationGuard can combine this information with the engineering files. And then you have a detailed description of all the assets, their firmware versions, and all the other parameters, such as the proper device name and description. This can be even combined with active communication, active device interrogation using StationGuard, and then you can reach a combined view of your asset inventory. How do I integrate such an intrusion detection system into the substation? There is a simple way for legacy substations, and there are more advanced steps possible. For legacy substations, StationGuard provides a dashboard for central monitoring to see in which substations do I have an alarm. And we also provide binary contacts so that a binary contact operates on each IDS alarm. And then this can be wired to an RTU and easily integrated into the SCADA signal list. And that's an easy way to have the alert status visible in the SCADA control room. More advanced methods is the integration into software used in security operation centers, such as SIEM systems, security incident information and event management systems. And for this, we're providing a syslog interface, which integrates into most systems from all different vendors. What is also available is an integration into ticket systems, and then you can make sure that the alerts automatically create tickets assigned to the engineers responsible for the particular asset. So these are the options how StationGuard can be integrated. This brings me to the conclusion. There are many different attack vectors possible for substations, especially considering their whole life cycle. Security solutions, such especially like intrusion detection systems, must speak the language of the protection and SCADA engineers. Otherwise, the response processes become inefficient. And there are tailor-made IDS solutions for energy systems available, such as StationGuard. And with this, I want to thank you very much for your attention.